Now, let us study the charge in a uniform magnetic field. Whenever you put charge in a uniform magnetic field, how will it act? Okay, what will be the path of that charge particle that we are going to study here? Okay, so for that, let me consider one thing that let me have a charge particle moving in this direction. Okay, this is my charge particle moving in this direction, and I will consider a positive charge with the velocity v which is going in this direction, right? So it will experience a force, definitely it will experience a force given by the Lorentz force. F is equal to q v cross of b. Okay, and whenever I write it in the scalar form, this will be v equals to q vb sine of theta that we have already studied. Okay, so what is b is magnetic field, what is v is the velocity, and what is the theta is the angle between velocity and the magnetic field. So if you look at here, the magnetic field is going inside like this. And okay, this is the magnetic field going inside, and this is the direction of the velocity, which is in this direction. So if you look at this, what is the angle? It is 90 degrees. Okay, so the angle here is 90 degrees. So what I get it, QVB. The force is this much. Okay, the force experienced by this charge particle, I'm considering only the positive charge particle, not the negative charge particle. Okay, for negative charge particle, I will go in the next lecture. Okay, where it is very important to study about the negative charge also. Why I am writing this, that we'll study later. Because here, if I write sine of 90 degree, sine of say 90 degree will give me what? It will give me 1. So basically what we are studying is, we are studying the case in which angle between magnetic field and the velocity is 90 degrees. Okay, please remember this one. Please remember, angle between this magnetic field and the velocity is 90 degrees. It is a very special case. Now, it will experience a force, but in which direction? Okay, so to find the force experienced by this charge, we use the Fleming's left hand rule. Okay, we use the Fleming's left hand rule. So in Fleming's left hand rule, what it gives is, it gives the force experienced by the charge or force experienced by the current carrying conductor. So it gives what? It gives force. Okay, please remember, force experienced by conductor, current carrying conductor, please remember, current carrying conductor or charge. Okay, it gives the force experienced by a current carrying conductor or a charge. Okay, instead of current carrying conductor, I have a charge here. For current carrying conductor, you have studied this in class 10. In class 12 also, we are going to study later. So, how to remember? Okay, so in Fleming's left hand rule, what we do is, we place the three fingers like this. Okay, this is my thumb, index finger, and the middle finger. Middle finger. So, don't laugh when I say middle finger. Okay, so it is physics. So, we have to place, okay, we have to consider all this finger in such a way that all the angles are 90 degrees. They are mutually perpendicular. If you see here, this is 90 degrees, this is 90 degrees, this is also 90 degrees, and this, okay, this and this is also 90 degrees. So, all the angles are 90 degrees. So, three fingers denote different things. So, this will denote the force, okay. Force, direction of force, and this will give the direction of magnetic field. Okay, direction of magnetic field, and this will give the direction of current. Direction of current, slash charge. Okay, so here we are considering the charge. So how to remember this? To remember this, I will call this as father. Okay, father. Father means F force, and this is my mother. Mother is magnetic field, and this is charge or current is my child. Okay, so remember father, mother, child. Okay, father, mother, child. Father, mother, child. Force, direction of magnetic field. Mother, current, C, charge. Okay, or the child. Okay, father, mother, and child. So before going to this, you have to understand one thing. Okay, so if it is a conductor and this is the flow of current I, okay, and here if the electron or the negative Q is flowing, okay, negative charge, it could be electron, or I would rather write electron is flowing, then in which direction it is flowing? So this current is going from left direction to right direction, and we know the electron will flow from left to right to the left, because if it is my positive, if it is my positive and if it is my negative, what we know is current flow from positive to negative direction like this, but the charge or the electron flow from negative to positive direction. So this will flow in this direction because this is negative. This is negative. Now if I will consider another conductor, so I will consider another conductor, say this is the direction of current, okay, from positive to negative. But here what I consider is, I will consider this as positive charge, okay, or a alpha particle. Okay, so charge is flowing. Whenever charge is flowing, there will be a current. So here I have considered a positive charge. In negative charge, the direction of current is opposite to the direction of flow of the electron. But whenever I consider a positive charge, the flow of charge is in the same direction. Okay, please remember. It means that the charge will flow in the same direction with the direction of current if the charge is positive. And if the charge is negative, the direction of the current and the charge is opposite. So here it is a positive charge, then current will flow from this direction to this direction, because direction of current and direction of charge is same in positive. So because I need the definition of current, I need the flow of current, because this is my child, father, mother, and child. Okay, so in which direction this charge will experience a force? So we have to use the Fleming's left hand rule, because it gives the force experienced by conductor, current carrying conductor, or a charge. Okay, so what is the direction of current? It is in the direction of velocity. Velocity going like this. So if you see here, the 90 degree, okay, angle between the magnetic field and the velocity is also 90 degree. Magnetic field going inside and the current, okay, charge is going that side like this. So this is 90 degree. So in which direction it will give the force? So let me use the Fleming's left hand rule. So I will point this in the direction of magnetic field, this in the direction of current, then automatically this thumb will give the direction of force. So the magnetic field, is going inside, the current is going in this direction because this is positive velocity. And whenever I do it like this, if you see this one, magnetic field going inside, okay, the current is going in this direction and the force will experience in above direction. So because of the force applied in this direction, it will tend to go in this direction. Okay, it will tend to go in this direction. Now with the velocity V, okay, now what happens is, if you see the force, what is the direction, what is the angle between force, current and magnetic field? It is always 90 degree. So from here, there will be a force acting in this direction in 90 degrees. So this is my force. Okay, again, because of this force, Fleming's left hand rule, it will tend to go in this direction, it will tend to go in this direction, right? Okay, this is velocity. Understood? Now if you see this again, here also the magnet, okay, here also the force will be coming inside, okay, in this direction in perpendicular fashion, okay, because of this, this is again force. Now if you look at this, the magnetic field is going inside, the current, this charge is flowing from down to up, so this is thus, the force is in this direction. So because of this force in this direction, this charge will tend to move in this direction, okay, in this direction. So this charge will tend to move in this direction with this velocity v. Again, the force is acting perpendicularly in this direction, okay. So again, what happens is, this is also force. Again, because of this force, it will tend to move in this direction, it will tend to move in this direction like this with the velocity v and the force downward. Again it will tend to move in this direction like this, okay, like this with the velocity v. Again it will tend to move in this direction with the velocity v. Again it will tend to move in this direction with the velocity v. Okay, so every time what is the force is inside, it is inside, it is inside, it is inside, it is inside. So every time the force is acting inside, and this kind of force is called centrifugal. Okay, now if I join all the lines from this, if I join all this line like this, I will get a circle. It means that whenever we put a positive charge or a negative charge in a uniform electric field, it will undergo a circular motion. Okay, to show this one, let me consider the circular motion here like this. So whenever I have a charged particle, it will undergo a circular motion with the certain radius r. So this is the trajectory, path of the charged particle followed in a uniform magnetic field. If I consider a point here, what is the direction of charge or direction of velocity? In this direction is the velocity v, and this is the direction of force. Here, this is the direction of velocity, and this is the direction of force. Okay, here, this is the direction of velocity, this is the direction of force. Here, direction of velocity in this direction, and this is the direction of force. It is how it looks like. So it will follow a circular path, centripetal force. Okay, some force, this force is attracting inside, this force is trying to get discharge inside, but there is something called centripetal force which is acting like this. Because of that centripetal force and this Lorentz force, it is in a circular motion. It means that the Lorentz force is equal to the centripetal force, isn't it? So what I can get is, this Lorentz force is equal to the centripetal force. Okay, centripetal force. So what is my Lorentz force? This is the Lorentz force. So I will get QVB is equal to centripetal force, we know, MV square by R. Okay, so MV square by R, because centripetal force. And what is M? M is the mass of this charge, V is the velocity, and R is the radius of the circular path followed by this charged particle. Again, please remember, I am not doing it for the negative charge. So, now let me find the equation of radius, okay? Equation of radius. Equation of radius. Okay, equation of radius. How can I find is, I have to use this equation. Okay, so what I know is, I have got qv of b is equal to mv square by r, and this velocity v cancels with this square, and I get qb, you bring this r here, r is equal to m into v. Okay, so next is, what I want to find, please see, the radius, or I will get, what do I get? I get the radius r is equal to mv divided by qb. So sometime in examination, it is asked to find the radius. So we got the radius. So we got the radius like this, r is equal to mv qb. Okay, r is equal to mv qb. Okay, so let me find the time. Okay, how much time it take to cover a one complete cycle. Okay, so that is called my time period. Okay, let me find the time period by this. Okay, so to find the time period, it is very simple. We use the very common formula, that is space, that is speed equal to distance by time. So we find the equation of, now equation of time period, equation of time period. So what do I mean by time period? We know that time period is the time taken by this charge to complete one cycle. If it starts from point P and it travels like this, and again it goes to this point. So from this and making a complete cycle, how much time is taken by this charge particle is my time period. Okay, so to do so, what we know is, we know speed equal to, very simple, speed is equals to distance upon time. Okay, or I want this time. So if you bring this time here, I will get t is equal to distance, say l, divided by speed is v. Okay, or c. So I get time is equal to l by v. Again, what is l? So again, I will do like this. You can always make this in some rough copy or at the side of your copy. So this is r. If the point P is here, starting and moving, again coming this, how much path is covered by this particle? It is the total length from this point to, again, this point, that is the circumference. Okay, that is the circumference. So L is my circumference. So this is equal to, what is L? The circumference, that is 2 pi into the radius, and radius we have calculated this as r divided by v. Okay, divided by v. Now from here I can always calculate v. So what is the value of v? You just do it like this, r into qb, you bring it here and you bring m downward, this will be my m is equal to v. So let me put this value over here. Okay, so if I put this value, what I get is, instead of v, I can write this r qb by m. So r qb divided by m. Okay, now what happens is, the denominator, this denominator will multiply in the numerator. Before that, this r and this r will cancel. So I will get 2 pi divided by qm, and this m will go up, and this will become m. So this is my time period. It is very simple. Now we got equation of radius, we got equation of time period. Now let me go to the angular frequency. Okay, let me go. Next is my angular frequency. It is not too difficult. You have to understand the things. It is very easy. First, what you do is, the centripetal force is equal to the Lorentz force. Okay, qvv is equal to mv square by r. From there you get v. Okay, and then speed equals to distance by time. From this you will get the time. So next is angular frequency. Angular frequency. Equation of angular frequency. Equation of angular frequency. Okay, equation of angular frequency. So what we know is, before going to the angular frequency, let me define the frequency first. What is frequency? We know frequency f is equal to 1 by t. Okay, everyone knows this. 1 divided by time period will give you the frequency. Okay, what is frequency now? You have a circular path, okay, with the radius r. And let me consider this point P. Okay, in one second, how many times this charged particle is making one complete cycle? That is my frequency. If it is making a 50 complete cycle in 1 second, then that is my 50 frequency. And if it is making 25 complete cycle in 1 second, matlab in 1 second it is passing this point how many times? 25 times. So that is my frequency. But if you see here, what do I have is, I have a circular path. Okay, now I am going to the concept of angular frequency. So first, what does it do is, this charge will stay here, and from this it will go to this point. Okay, first it will go to this point. And how much is this angle? First, it is making 90 degree, which is equal to pi by 2. First, it is traveling. It was just like this, traveling pi by 2. And then in the second case, it will reach here from this point to this point, and it is making again one more 90 degree, that is 180 degree angle. This and this is 180 degree, which is equal to pi, angle pi. Again, what happens is, it will go to this point, from this to this, and making another 90 degree. So this is 270 degree, which is 3 pi by 2. Okay, so this is 3 pi by 2. Now next, what does it do is, it will travel from this and again reach here, making a complete cycle with this, and one more 90 degree. So this is 360 degree is equal to 2 pi. Okay, so why I am writing all these things, it is because that it is not moving in a straight line. It is not a linear frequency. It is rather an angular frequency, because it is making angle 90 degree, 180, 270, 360, again more angle like this, right? So I am writing angular frequency. So in 1 second, how many times it is making one complete cycle? So in one complete cycle, it is making how many degrees? It is making 2 pi. So I have to write this as angular frequency, not the linear frequency. So to do so, I will multiply this with 2 pi, because it is making a circle into 2 pi. Now this term, whole term, will become angular frequency, which is denoted by omega. So this is my omega equal to 2 pi by t. Very simple. I want to find the angular frequency. Frequency is 1 by t. So I multiply 2 pi here also, 2 pi here also. This will become angular frequency. Now how much is time? So that is very simple. Let me put it. So this is giving me 2. Okay, this is giving me 2 pi. And the time is, again, 2 pi m whole divided by qv. And if you look at here, this 2 pi and this 2 pi will cancel, and you will get how much? This term will go in the top, so this will become qv by m. So this is angular frequency. Okay, so this is angular frequency, and angular frequency its definition is its SI unit is second inverse or hertz. Hertz in symbol, this can be written as atom, because this has no unit, it has second. So if you bring it above, it will become 10 to the power minus, I mean s to the power minus 1, that is second inverse. So it is very simple. Now the main thing here you need to remember is, whenever you put a charged particle in uniform magnetic field, it will experience a force, and because of that force it will undergo a circular motion. That is the concluding note, you have to write that. It will undergo a circular motion. Now what is the direction? How to find the direction? It is found by using Fleming's left hand rule. Okay, in this case it is 90 degrees. Okay, it is always 90 degrees. Next thing, if the charge carrier is negative, then the direction of current and the direction of charge is opposite, because current is going from positive to negative. Electron, that is negative charge, is going from negative to positive. But lekin yaad karo beta ki agar current positive se negative mein ja raha hai, or if you have the positive charge carrier, then this positive charge will also move from positive to negative. This we are going to use in the next lecture, and which is very important as for the board examination. Okay, so thank you.